Monday morning. It's June 20th. I'm meteorologist Quaylen Murphy with your tropics update. We have a graduation from tropical depression to tropical storm Danielle earlier this morning. That system close to making its way onto land, but still offshore right now. Winds of 45 miles per hour. As of the latest information from the National Hurricane Center, still moving west at around 7 miles per hour. You can see all the cloud cover associated with the system, but Danielle developing at the time that it has makes it the earliest fourth named storm on record. Prior to that, it was Debbie, June 23rd, 2012. So Danielle already down in the history books. Right now, we see lots of rainfall here. Very much not a structured system right now. We do have lots of showers and storms, though, around the structure, more elongated. So working from northwest to southeast where we find those thunderstorms. And this particular forecast or area radar not picking up on all of the moisture, but you can see with the satellite that expanse of showers and storms along the coast. We expect that to continue throughout the afternoon hours into the evening of Monday and into early Tuesday. That rainfall potential 6 to 10+ inches possible for some locations around eastern Mexico, even extending north towards Brownsville, Texas in the coming days. So just some isolated rain action for Texas and more of that included for eastern Mexico through the next couple of 24 hours, let's say. So moving west at 7 miles per hour. To our north, we find quieter conditions around the Gulf of Mexico. This lingering stationary front south of the Florida Straits, some rainfall around the Florida Keys. North of that, we find high pressure, which is keeping things pretty solid, consistent around the Gulf of Mexico. So quieter conditions and some drier air building in, which is right around New Orleans. We'll see rain-free conditions pretty much for the remainder of the week. So here's the Gulf of Mexico, Caribbean Sea. Then we have the Atlantic Ocean. Again, things pretty much quiet. A few couple tropical waves around Hispaniola, and those also building out towards the Leeward Islands. We have an area of low pressure around Colombia, but nothing to write home about as far as these low pressures are concerned. Even out in the Atlantic Ocean, we find some drier air mixing in around that monsoon trough. Not too much going on, at least for the time being. We don't expect any tropical development within the next 2 to 5 days. Now, the week to watch will be the week of June 26th through July 2nd. We do have one model that's indicating we could see some development in the Caribbean Sea, and that could be moving northward into the Gulf of Mexico. So that would be something we'll be watching from Louisiana all the way over towards the coast of Florida in the coming days. So this is next week, June 26th. 26th through July 2nd, and looking really here around the southern parts of the Caribbean as we could see some pieces of energy breaking off. So something to look not forward to, but something to monitor in the coming weeks. No surprise, because we see most of our tropical storms breeding around these areas in the Gulf, the Caribbean Sea, and also in the western Atlantic. That goes for the month of June. And also as we extend towards the month of July, pretty much the same setup and similar conditions favorable for development in the same locations around the Gulf of Mexico, Caribbean Sea, and the Atlantic Ocean. So certainly we'll keep our eyes poised to the tropics around the Caribbean and the Gulf as we move into the next week or two. For the next 7 days, though, quiet rainfall, as I mentioned, on the lower side, really hard to come by in the next 7 days. And those temperatures low to mid 90s, overnight lows in the 70s. Get ready for more heat. Today marks the day one of summer. Summer solstice taking place at 5:34. And that's about it. All we wrote there for heat and humidity across the area. That's your latest tropics update. Thanks for joining us here online.